Hey everyone, I've had a couple of requests to make a video about what I eat in a day. So I thought I'd go through everything that I eat in a typical day. Hopefully this can also help those people wanting to go vegan as well, just so you can get a bit of an idea of what it's like to eat vegan. I predominantly stick to a whole food plant-based diet because I'm very health conscious, so I avoid processed foods as much as possible, but of course I still enjoy food and I'll still eat chocolate and ice cream, that sort of thing, in moderation. But yeah, this is basically what I eat typically. Usually I start my day off just having a coffee. When I'm working, I usually fast, and so I won't break my fast until about 11 o'clock. I highly recommend that you actually look into the science behind fasting so you can do it safely if you are interested. It has a lot of health benefits to it. Only do this if you are an adult. So it's 10:45. I'm about to technically break my fast even though I've had a coffee earlier on, and I'm going to make a smoothie. Sometimes I will do a workout in the morning before I eat. Sometimes I don't. It really depends how I'm feeling. It's super important to actually listen to your body and eat if you need to, if you're hungry. So today I haven't worked out yet, but I probably will after I have this smoothie. It's a really nice day today. The sun's out. It's been raining in Perth for a while, so I'm really excited to get back on my bike and go for a bike ride to the beach. So yeah, I haven't really done anything this morning. I actually just went and picked up the West Australian newspaper. And guess who's in it? Super cool. So yeah, let's get this smoothie started. Okay, so this smoothie I'm making for myself and my mum. So this is not just all for me. So I will start off putting 2 cups of water in the smoothie. Obviously, it's your personal choice if you prefer to use like soy or almond milk instead, but I find water is totally fine in my smoothies. All right, so linseeds, also known as flax seeds, are a really great source of omega-3. Usually I actually grind the flax seeds up because they're absorbed better by the body, but I believe that when I put them in the smoothie, they grind up anyway, but yeah, preferably you do want to have ground up flax seeds. I follow Dr. Michael Greger and he recommends 1 tablespoon a day of flax seeds. Lemon, super good. So water, flax seeds and lemon. It's really important to have a source of fats whenever you're having something like a smoothie or a salad. So you can actually absorb all the nutrients. So I like to put a bit of avo in my smoothies as well. All right, now I'm going to put some kale into the smoothie. I find it a really great way to add in your greens in a smoothie. Don't even taste it. So yeah, I just load it up with kale. And I'll add in a couple of bananas. And of course, berries. So this one is just mixed berries, raspberries, blueberries, strawberries. There we go. I want you by my side so that I never feel alone again. They've always been so kind, but now they brought you away from me. I hope they didn't get your mind. Mum doesn't like having protein powder in hers, so once I pour hers out, I add this in. It's a really nice mix of like cacao powder and a few other different things, so I just like to add it in because it tastes nice. It's not really necessary. And sometimes I'll also add in greens powder, but I literally just ran out yesterday. But I buy the brand, I think it's Raw. I'll have to get back to you on that. I'm pretty sure it's Raw, and it's just like a mix of green powders as well. We can bring it on the floor. Never danced like this before. We don't talk about a dancer. So nice, and I'm now going to have lunch. So I'm going to show you exactly what I put in my salad every day. This is a super nutritious salad and it's so yummy as well. So I'm just making a bit of a beetroot mix, which I put into my salad. Nice fresh beetroots. So I'll just mix this with some apple cider vinegar. And a little bit of date syrup. This is a fantastic alternative to honey. So I'll just start off with quinoa. Quinoa is super, super nutritious, so I just kind of load it up in there. And turmeric, I have this every day, and it's recommended by Dr. Greger to have a quarter of a teaspoon of turmeric every day. Super, super healthy stuff. I also mix it with black pepper because it increases the absorption. These are Dulse flakes. Like, I just put the tiniest bit in. But yeah, great source of iodine, super important. Like, any kind of seaweed has a fantastic source. Some more avo again. I don't really have too much, just a little bit. As I mentioned earlier, it is important to have a source of fat in your smoothies and your salads. So, beetroot. And my favorite, sweet potato. Really load up on the sweet potato. Carbs for life. I'll add in chickpeas. Got my greens. So sometimes I'll have just spinach, or I'll mix it up with like parsley or whatever, like basil, whatever I've got growing in the garden. I'm sometimes I have tempeh as well, but I'm not going to have that today because I got heaps of chickpeas in there anyway. But tempeh, so good. So, so good. So yeah, I got some more sources of fat and omegas in these hemp seeds. So I'll just sprinkle a reasonable amount on. Pepita seeds as well. And some nooch, also called nutritional yeast. I can't find my way out of here. I want you by my side. So that I'll never feel alone again. Love wants you. We can bring it on the floor. If never dance like this. I'm not going to show you what I have for dinner because I'm too lazy. But I'll just show you the recipe book that I cook most of my foods from. So it's called How Not to Die Cookbook. Again, by my favorite Michael Greger. And this one is my absolute favorite recipe. The lentil bolognese is just amazing. Otherwise, I'll usually eat like a chickpea curry or what else? Burritos, burgers, like a black bean Mexican bowl. But yeah, I'll put a link. There's also some free recipes on Plant Proof because yeah, you do have to buy this book. But if you want free recipes, I'll link a couple of websites where you can find free recipes for all kind of vegan foods.